The process of getting bound and then unbound is charged with immense significance. The soul gets mixed up with the body and then gets caught up with it. The soul is like a parrot and the body is like a cage. When the parrot is outside of the cage, it is free, but it does not fully appreciate what freedom is. Not having known confinement, it does not recognize being outside of the cage as freedom. When it goes through encagement, the agonizing bondage causes it to appreciate what freedom really is. Then, when the parrot is set free again, it truly enjoys its freedom. The same thing happens to the soul when, through the grace of the perfect master, it is freed from the limiting nightmare in which it believes itself to be nothing but its own encaging body.
Dynamic freedom. The unlimited freedom of the truth-realized person is the only real and full freedom. Only in such dynamic freedom flowing through a perfect master can the self as truth manifest itself. Thus expressing the divinized impressions of the universal mind. The divinized impressions are infinitely creative and efficient because they are infinitely submissive to the self. They release creative and divine action, which is unlimited. But the ordinary binding impressions of the ego mind are unendingly aggressive to the self and seek their own fulfillment. They are thus infinitely limited in efficiency and creativity.